Hi guys, first of all apologies for not doing the news bulletin yesterday. We had some technical issues because of which we couldn't continue the news bulletin part. Today we'll start fresh and these are the highlights of the day. Sports Minister Kiran Rijiju visits Sports Authority of India headquarters where the essential staff has already resumed the office. The minister said that we have started office with minimum staff, though we are taking all the precautionary measures from wearing masks to social distancing. They're doing it all. The office was shut down on March 21st as a precautionary measure to contain the virus, and now the ministers are asked to join back. Equestrian Fuad Mirza says that Olympic postponement is a blessing in disguise. The 28-year-old Mirza, who had won 2 silver medals in the Asian Games in 2018, said that the Olympic postponement will not only give him time to practice but also give the horses time to rest. Two of India's best and most experienced cricketers have accepted that being out of action for this long will definitely affect their performance in the upcoming World Cup. Mithali Raj and Jhulan Goswami have restricted themselves to 50-over form of cricket, and Raj has also said that it will be a little difficult for them to come back to cricket once the lockdown is over. She also said that during the initial days of the lockdown, it was very difficult and she was frustrated, but as it went on, she formed herself a schedule to follow. While Jhulan said that she was looking to play competitive cricket before directly playing the international matches. Finally, a sporting event that has been confirmed: India to host Asian Boxing Championship in the month of November and December. There is no confirmation on the host city because I think people are waiting for the things to normalize and then probably they will announce the host city. The National Federation announced it today, that is Monday, and they showed confidence that by that time COVID-19 pandemic will be under control. African footballers have been stranded in India and they see no hope of returning home. With domestic and international travel bans in place, these footballers have been left stranded in India. European footballers have contacted their embassies and they might get some help, but with African footballers, there's no such help guaranteed. That's it from my end, guys. Don't forget to like and share our video.